everyone. First, let me introduce myself. My name is Arina Bila, and today I would like to show you about the book that I have been read and resume in my blog. By the way, if you want to see about my resume, you can click the link below. So, this is the book. And the title is 7 Myths About Education by Daisy Christodoulou. And there are 7 chapters in this book, and today I would like to explain about each chapter in these videos. So we can start right now. Let's get started. The first chapter's title is Fact Befriend Understanding. In this book, Daisy tells us about a lot of experts says that the student has to learn by their own experience, and the teacher give a lot of project and homework to learning. But in here also, Daisy tell us about the researchers found that everything we hear, everything we see, and everything we think about is critically dependent on our long-term memory. And if we doesn't know about the facts, we can know everything. If we learn about the facts, it makes us to know a new fact more easier because it's already in our long-term memory. The title of the chapter 2 is Teacher-led Instruction is Passive. In the first chapter, some of the experts say that it's better to give the experience for the student to learning. So there will be more discussion between the students rather than the teacher transmitting the knowledge. And the expert says if the teacher only transmitting the knowledge to the student, it will make the student become passive and it's not effective. But in here, Daisy say that actually the teacher instruction is necessary for the independent learner. Because the only way to learn independently to be done is for the student who work with the knowledge that they already know. The title of this chapter is 21st Century Fundamentally Changes Everything. Some experts always think about the 21st century skills because of the changes of the technology and economy. We can't teach the way we always have done. 21st century have to think critically, solve problem, collaborate, create, or innovate. But human already have done most of this for a quiet long time. The title of the fourth chapter is You Can Always Just Look It Up. In the previous chapter, we can know that there are a lot of changes in the technology and economy in the 21st century, and it's often being a reason why we have to teach about the skills in the 21st century. The point of this argument is we don't have to worry about teaching facts because a lot of new information technology that we can access easier. But our long-term memory is not a bolt-on part of our brain's architecture, but instead integral to our mental process. In this chapter, Daisy said that you can only rely on being able to look something up when you know a quiet bit about it to begin with. The title of the fifth chapter is We Should Teach Transferable Skills. In this chapter, a lot of people say that we have to teach about the how, not about the what. teach the student about how they can solve problems, how they can analyze, how to critical thinking, and how to evaluate. But how can we ensure the students can develop these skills? What the important is the practice when we have to retrieving a specific piece of knowledge, not about the generic ability in retrieving any piece of knowledge. In this chapter, the title is Project and Activities Are the Best Way to Learn. In this chapter show us that a lot of schools involve a project and activities for their learning process. And the purpose of these activities and project is to replicate the real world problem and to make the students think critically like the expert do. But we don't have to be an expert to solve any problem in this world. We just have to know about the knowledge and practice about the knowledge itself. And the title of the last chapter is Teaching Knowledge is Indoctrination. How can the teaching knowledge is indoctrination? Knowledge is a way to change everything in this world. In short, there are a progressive reason to support the teaching knowledge. Both in past and present have recognized this. The knowledge is not indoctrination, but knowledge is liberates. And I think that's all that this book is tells about. And in my opinion, if you are an educational department students, you have to read about this book, because this book is really good. And besides all of the myth that the Daisy tells us, we can also know about the best method we can use for teaching the students. Once again, if you want to see about my resume, you can check it out on my blog and just click the link below. Thank you for watching.